questions regarding anything regarding our code of conduct, please make sure that you see me or anyone else on the staff afterwards. Part of this program has been to find the best speakers that we can on the topic. We've brought in attorneys in the past. We've brought in narcotics experts, detectives, and police officers. It's always been a very informational meeting that we have, and tonight will be no exception. Following this meeting, there will be a couple of groups are going to meet with their particular teams. I know that all the football parents, they'll have a meeting here. At that time, players will take the pledge as far as what your code of conduct is, your training rules. So we will let you know which teams are going to meet afterwards. Our speaker tonight is Father Jacob Meyer. Father Jacob is our new co-chaplain. He was newly ordained this past May. He's originally from Granger, Indiana, where he attended Penn High School. After his high school graduation, he attended Ball State and earned a degree in business. He went on to attend seminary school at the Josephinum in Columbus, Ohio. His home parish is St. Pius of Granger. He is currently assigned as the parochial vicar at St. Charles. We welcome Father Jacob here tonight and ask you to listen attentively to his message. Father Jacob.
One thing you're going to know about me real quick is that most pulpits aren't big enough for me. I outgrow most things, and up here, I needed more space. So I'm going to come down and walk amongst you. But what we're going to talk about here tonight is code of conduct, yes. But what is at the core of the code of conduct? What is the point of all these rules, of all these regulations, of all this information that we're trying to get you to? The ultimate goal, brothers and sisters, is to get you to heaven. That is our ultimate goal at Mission Dwenger. This isn't just to make you outstanding citizens. It's going to do that. But it's going to do much more. It's going to make you, and each and every one of you, and your parents, and your whole families, hopefully, witnesses to the gospel in our community. Because what we are called to as citizens of two worlds is to be countercultural. Now, what does that mean for us? Brothers and sisters, we don't live in a world anymore where Christianity, all of our values, what we are about here at Bishop Dwenger, is supported by our community. Those times are long gone, and it's time that we wake up as members of this society and realize that. We no longer live in a country that supports our values. We no longer live in a country where we can just trust that our kids can go to the mall and come out looking like they're supposed to look. You let your kid loose in the mall with a credit card, that's dangerous, right? And they probably aren't going to come out looking dressed like you like. We don't have those natural support systems. And so what does that mean for us? That means that when we go to make all these decisions in our life, we have to first off assume that we're going to have to make tough decisions. We have to assume as parents, as students, as members of this city, that we are to be the witness now. We can't count on everyone else to be the witness. It's time for us to lead. And at Bishop Dwenger, we have a great opportunity to do that. I'm looking right now at probably over 1,000, I don't know, people in our community that are here for one purpose, and that is to better their lives. And I hope that this message about countercultural activity helps you to do that. And so what do I mean by countercultural? How does that look practically in your life? That means that everything that we do, everything that we are about, has to be about living out our faith, living out our values, outside of these walls, outside the four walls of a church. Because if we can't live it outside those walls, what are we about? That's the ultimate hypocrisy, right? We're going to go to church on Sundays, but we're not going to walk the walk in the real world. That's not what Jesus wants. That's not what you're being called to do. And so this has to affect every single part of your life. And parents, I'm going to primarily address you throughout this whole talk, because if you're not walking the ways of faith, if you're not being a good example for your Dwenger students, they're never going to get why this is important. It's so important to be a parent nowadays. You're saying, you know, okay, whippersnapper freeze, how on earth do you know? Tell me about it, right? You don't have kids in high school. But I see your kids in high school, and I know how much they desire to be led by example, most of all by you, even if they don't show it. And so first things first, as Bishop Dwenger parents, and then also, by extension, all of our students, first thing we got to do to be countercultural is we got to put God first. We got to put God first in every single aspect of our life. And if He's not there, we got to make Him there. Church has to be a priority, end of story, right? Sunday Mass. That would be the most tragic thing for me, to hear a student say, I got to ask my parents to take me to Mass. That needs to be an expectation, brothers and sisters. Because if we aren't giving our due to God, if we are not rendering unto God what is due to Him out of justice, out of His sacrifice for us, by that cross, He suffered and died so that we might have life, so that we might have this entire institution. Out of justice, that 1 hour a week is due to Him. And we got to put that first in our lives. Over sports, over activities, over everything, God's got to be first. Because if we do that, we're going to be having a great witness for our community. Secondly, by putting God first in your life, by making Mass a priority, everything else has to change around that. The way we dress, the way we look, the way we talk, what we do, how we do it, all of those things have to be affected by our central goals, our central values, the fact that we are Catholics. When we go into that mall, and we're going to pick out our clothes, or we're going to buy the latest things, are we thinking like a Catholic? Are we thinking with terms of modesty, first and foremost? You all got that letter last year about prom, right? You're going to get a little earlier this time. But it's going to be coming. Because modesty is something that we can't count on the trends to support. Modesty is something that we first of all have to model in all of our dress. Not just in the prom dresses, but all the time. When our kids leave our homes, they should be looking like they have respect for their bodies. And we have to model that as well. Now, that's really hard to do. I'm not saying that's going to be easy, because let's all be honest, there's not a lot out there, right? Our culture isn't supporting that way of life. But it can be done. And I challenge you to think about that. What else has to change if we're going to be countercultural? If we're going to be countercultural, our homes have to change. Our very lives, everything that happens in those four walls, whatever happens in the four walls of the church, that has to happen within the four walls of your house. Prayer can't just be something that's relegated to this school or to the church. Prayer has to be something that you live in your home. When people walk into your house, they should know you're a Christian. When people walk in that front door, they should know by the very atmosphere that you have surrounded yourself and your children with, that this is a house in which God dwells. And how do you do that? Most of us are Catholics here. How do you do that? Crucifix, an image of Our Lady. When you gather around that table for a meal, you say a prayer. There's a spirit of prayer there. Those things have to be there. Because if you don't take what's in those four walls of that church, and if you don't put it in your home, our kids, our families, our visitors, no one's going to be able to get the connection between a God who reigns in a tabernacle in a church and the God who reigns in every one of your hearts because of your baptism. We have to have a greater connection between those two things. The church and our homes, which are called a domestic church.